Hi Sunshines, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm taking it back to the days I didn't know how to edit. Except I do know how to edit, and I just wanted to show you guys how I apply my foundation every single time I am wearing foundation. Doesn't mean I wear foundation every single day, but every time I do a makeup routine, this is the foundation routine that I have been doing for quite a few months now, and I absolutely love it. I don't see myself doing anything else at the moment because I absolutely love it so much. This is my everyday foundation look, and it's something that's very light and I feel extremely comfortable with. I am very much more comfortable, and then I feel more beautiful when my foundation is more on the neutral and natural looking side. I do consider this a flawless foundation, but without it being full coverage. It's really not full coverage. I can still see my skin seeping through the color that I have on my face, but I don't mind it because it's just enough coverage for my comfort zone, if that makes any sense. All right, enjoy. So I have a clean face, except I already did my skincare part. So what I have on my face right now is just two little drops. Two little drops is all I need. From my argan oil, and I like to apply oils on my face. Oils are like my thing, but the powders that I apply suck up the oil pretty well, and it all looks amazing after. Sometimes for a little bit of more sunscreen and protection, I go in with my Kula mineral sunscreen, and this is an organic sun care with SPF 20. But I didn't use that today. Today I only used two drops of my argan oil, and then I go in with my eye gel from Alba, and I just apply two or three drops under each eye. I also let it sink in. I don't apply makeup right after because it does need to sink in. And the reason I use this is because it depuffs under the eyes, and dark circles aren't really my huge problem. My problem is the puffiness under the eyes. I have puffy eyes, and sometimes I get like a deep line and then the top is really puffy. Absolutely hate it. So I use this. So let's begin. Right now I'm just filling in my brows a little bit. I like to do that first before my foundation. I have a video on it. And for my brows, I just simply use an angled brush like this one with my brow powder. And now just to soften, I just brush it out like this with a brow brush. And it makes it a lot softer and natural looking. Finally, for my foundation, I start off with my primer. This is from 100% Pure, and it's a luminous primer that has vitamins and antioxidants. And this is a great brand with very pure organic ingredients. And I'd use a little bit on my hands, and I apply it on my cheekbones, forehead, the main points where I want a glowy look, but it really just goes everywhere. And for those of you who don't know, what a primer does is it creates a base for your foundation to ensure that it stays all day, and it also minimizes the pores on your face while also ensuring that your foundation looks flawless throughout the day and lasts longer. That's basically what it does. I take a little bit of my Josie Maran, just one pump of my Josie Maran Instant Self-Adjusting Serum Foundation. So it starts off light. This is the darkest color they have, which is medium dark. It starts off light and then it goes on adjusting to my natural skin color. While it's still adjusting, I take this Olema Pure number 23 stippling brush as well. It's just like a fluffy stippling brush, and I take this Olema Pure Radiant Finishing Powder, which is just a radiant finishing powder that has, it's like a bronzy color that has some sparkles on it. And this isn't really to add coverage, this just adds a little color and dimension to my face. So I put a little bit on here and then on my brush, and I go around the edges of my face. So I'm gonna apply this on the cheeks, a little bit on the side of my forehead, and on my chin. concealer is by RMS, and I just simply take my finger and tap it under my eyes. And I just apply what I feel I need, but I also like to use it as a brightener. I will set it after with a really good powder that I can't wait to show you guys. I also add a little bit of the remainings from my finger down my nose to add a little bit of definition, and I just tap that in as well. Never rub, always tap. So tapping everything in basically just blends things in without moving around whatever you applied prior to the concealer. So it covers up more and also much more gentle around the eyes. So when I'm tapping, I'm just making sure that I'm tapping it in a triangle form. From the corner of your eye to the tip of your nostril, going upwards towards your temple. And I just tap everything in until it's blended like this. There we go. So now I am taking my favorite powder of the moment, my face powder, which is from 100% Pure again. And this is the Healthy Flawless Skin Foundation Powder in the color Toffee. And it also has sun protection, so that's great for under the eyes. So what I like to do is, where's my brush? I take a big fluffy brush, doesn't have to be this one, it can literally be any brush that you have. This is a Sigma F30 large powder brush, and I take a little bit on there and I tap it under my eyes, focusing on the area that I just applied that concealer. Tap it once and then apply it under my eyes. I'm gonna take this Sigma angled shading brush in the number E70, and it's just an angled brush for the eyes, but I like to use a little bit of this down the sides of my nose to add a little bit of definition, because when we apply foundation, the definition, the natural definition of our face kind of goes away because everything is now just like one color. So I just take a little bit on the brush and I start shading in the sides. This isn't like the proper way of contouring because I don't really want to contour. I just want to bring back some light definition to my nose without it being too drastic or dramatic. And now my favorite thing to do is to take this blush from Alima Pure in the color Zinnia. This is also a luminous shimmer blush, but I don't really consider it a shimmer blush. I just know it's luminous. I can't stress enough how nice this blush is for my skin color. I'm completely obsessed with it. I've been using this since the summer started, and I think I'll be using this forever. That's how much I like it. Everything that I'm applying is extremely so light, so throughout the day when it starts to settle into my skin, it looks even nicer. I'm actually going to a wedding soon and I'm gonna have this exact foundation to the wedding because I've tried it so many times that it photographs really well, it looks nice in video. I take just a little tiny bit and I apply it on the tip of my nose. I'm obsessed with Carrie Bradshaw, Sarah Jessica Parker from Sex and the City, and in wintertime, the makeup artist would apply like a little extra blush on her nose because it makes her look like cold or like extra blushing. I know we're in summer, but I still like to do that on myself because I think it looks cute. Whatever's left, I just apply on my chin, which is not much. I usually always just take any eyeshadow that I like or has a golden or champagne kind of tone to it. Right now I'm taking more of a gold one and I'm just applying it on the highest part of my cheekbone. And that adds a little bit of a glow. See the difference? No glow, glow. No glow, glow. And then I pinch my brush a little bit so it's really thin. And I go down my nose. My go-to lipstick is this one from Juice Beauty, and it's the Alicia Silverstone collection, I believe, and this has no actual color. It's just a purely kissable lip color, and it's basically just a pink color. As you can see, I've worn it out like crazy, and I just dab a little bit of this on, tap it. The last thing I do is apply my mascara. This is a mascara by Dr. Hoshka, and it has the best ingredients The only thing is it kind of, like if I were to touch my eyelashes throughout the day, the black tint just comes off really easily, but I really love it and it makes my eyelashes really long. That smells like flowers and essential oils. Oh my goodness, it smells so good. I know that doesn't even mean anything for mascara to smell good. It doesn't have to smell good. I'm talking too much. This is why I don't do talk through videos, because I talk way too much and it makes no sense. So what I like to do with this, because I make a mess with mascara, I'm not perfect. So what I do is I take a sticker or a business card of whatever. This is a BeautyCon card, by the way. I will be at BeautyCon LA. Read description box below so you guys can meet me and I can meet you. So what I simply do is I just put the sticker or business card or whatever right there, and this way it's not going all over my eye, especially if I'm wearing eyeshadow on that day. I don't want the eyeshadow to get messed up and have a bunch of eyeshadow on top. I mean on top, a bunch of mascara on top of my eyeshadow. This is one coat, no coat. One coat, no coat. For those of you who tend to take a Q-tip and wet it with your spit or water or whatever and clean up any mascara, don't do that anymore. What that does, especially if you have eyeshadow, what that does is it'll smudge everything all around on your eye and it'll remove whatever eyeshadow you have on because you wet it. Leave your Q-tip dry, don't wet it. And once, continue on doing your makeup, and right before you're done or whenever your mascara that you made a boo-boo with dries on your lid, you take this and simply brush right on top very lightly and it just flicks off without making a mess. If you were to wet this, it will wet the mascara and make like a big black smudge because you're wetting the Q-tip. It just comes right off without making a mess in your eye. This is my go-to everyday foundation. I hope this was somewhat helpful for those of you who are beginners or those of you who are just interested in what kind of makeup I use for my foundation to just cover up a little bit, but not full coverage where your face can't breathe and your skin is completely covered. So this to me looks extremely natural. You can use less or more, whatever you choose. For all other information regarding my foundation and everything that I use in this video will be listed in the description box below this video as always, along with the BeautyCon info for Los Angeles. I hope I didn't bore you guys too much. Yeah, I love you guys. See you in the next video.